Art and humanity are two interrelated phenomena. For without art, there can be no humanity. And without humanity, there can be no art. Art and humanity can therefore be said to have a symbiotic relationship. For all art forms, whether kinetic or static, visual or performing, bear the mark of the creativity of humanity. From the ritualistic beginning of art, when murals and carvings depicting the spiritual as well as the cosmological essence of humanity were made to aid worship, to the performance of dances and ritual drama with the intent of adoration and worship, art sprouted in humanity. From the secular essence of art, where art is seen purely as a form of entertainment and social release, art also takes root in humanity. For the creativity of humanity to find expression, therefore, art must come to the fore, because the ethos, the norms, and the cultures of humanity is heavily dependent on art. Static and visual art. From the four-dimensional to the two-dimensional, visual art strives to mirror not just humanity, but also society. Because it is through the interaction among human beings that society is born. Art, born of humanity, therefore, must mirror society. Society exists on varying levels and strata, from the high to the low, from the nobility to the gentry. Humanity is therefore better understood when situated within the context of society. Life is art, and art is life. Why not so? A man will not leave a lucrative profession to take two arts. And the man I'm talking about is Christopher MBONU-EMEREM, who started out life as an economist, but took to art some 17 years ago. And ever since, it has been no looking back, because the man has continued to work strong and stronger. He's done a lot of exhibitions at home and abroad, and is beginning to garner enough support and enough clout in the international and in the local circuit. Let me not take your time. I welcome you into the gallery of Christopher MBONU-EMEREM. Christopher MBONU-EMEREM, a macro and micro economics turned a macro and micro artist. MBONU-EMEREM, a self-trained artist, celebrates the boisterousness of life as well as the somber side of existence in his works. Not so lettered in the philosophy of art, MBONU-EMEREM allows the beauty and character in his works to make a statement that is not only meaningful, but also timeless. Christopher MBONU-EMEREM, born some 43 years ago in Imo State, attended the University of Nigeria, Nsukka, where he majored in macro and microeconomics, but not finding fulfillment as an economist, decided to take to arts. And ever since, he has not looked back, because his works have been testament to the fact that a vocation taken seriously is better than a profession. And that is why Christopher MBONU-EMEREM has not looked back. Away from economics, his original profession, MBONU-EMEREM took to arts by intuition and not by instruction. He took to arts not by deliberate planning, but by divine design. During his youth service, MBONU-EMEREM distinguished himself in this adopted profession through painting the portraits of notable personalities such as the then head of state, General Muhammadu Buhari, and the then Kaduna State Military Governor, Air Vice Marshal Usman Muhazu, as well as the military governor of Imo State then, General Ike Nwachukwu. Having oiled his skills in the area of portraiture and having won recognition and awards, MBONU Christopher MBONU-EMEREM decided to go into full-time arts, thereby jettisoning his lettered profession.
I had my primary school education in community primary school, Obroekwe.
Okay.
Before I proceeded to Umaka High School in Njaba local government. After that, I finished my secondary school at Dohati Memorial Grammar School, Ijero Ekiti,
okay.
Former Ondo State.
Okay, now in Ekiti State.
Now Ekiti State.
Okay.
So from there, I took entrance to the university.
Okay.
Then I passed to read economics,
okay.
at the University of Nigeria, Soka, in the year 1979. I finished in 1983, specializing in mathematical economics and econometrics.
Econometrics, yes. I saw that in your curriculum vitae.
So, after the degree program,
yes,
I had to do my national service program. I was posted to Katsina Polytechnic.
Okay.
That was in 1983.
Okay.
It was there that this very talent of painting started. As a child, when I was in primary school, right from childhood, I was being called an artist because I took great delight in painting, in drawing, you know, sketching my classmates in primary school. That was in community primary school, as I said earlier. I took delight in doing that. Even when I was going to fetch food for our goat as a small kid, I normally used the pointed end of my knife to draw human beings, even draw goats, all these other animals. It was from there this very talent started. But the thing could not continue because at Umaka High School, there was nothing like fine arts being offered by the school. So I lost interest in that, and it did not only when we are doing biology, all these chemistry and all these other subjects that I tried to depict that I can draw. So it continued like that. It was during the service year, as I was saying before, that this very talent resurfaced. When I do the portrait of the governor of Kaduna State,
yes.
Then Usman Muazu. Then I do the man in charge of coppers, the chairman of the local government, the emir of Katsina, Kabir Usman,
yes.
And a host of other people. I do their paintings and their portraits.
Yes.
The kind of reception people, the attention people gave my work, made me to stay put in painting, in art. Until today.
Okay.
Now, but when I came back, after the service program, out of the corpus who were passing out that year,
yes.
In Kaduna State, my work was adjudged the best in the whole of that state to represent Kaduna State in the NYSC Honors Award Ceremony,
okay.
in Lagos State being the federal capital.
At that time.
So that was how the whole thing started.
Okay.
MBONU-EMEREM skills in the visual arts cut across the four-dimensional medium to the two-dimensional medium. The message of his art, though centered around the celebration of humanity, is portrayed through impressionism and expressionism, to reality as well as surrealism. MBONU-EMEREM's stroke on the canvas of time, far from being an eclectic stroke of an untrained hand, are imprints of a master on a familiar terrain.
Mr. MBONU-EMEREM, sorry, what is the title of this work?
The title of this work is Bride and Her Attendant Maidens.
Okay. What really can we say inspired this work, you know, as an artist? What inspired you to do this work?
Yes, in fact, this is one of the most fascinating works out of my collections.
Okay.
Out of my collections. In fact, I grew up in my community, which is the Igbo community.
Okay.
And all the time, when any girl is getting married,
okay,
she will invite all her friends to come and decorate her, to bid her the final farewell to her husband's place.
Okay.
That is why in this very particular painting, you see three girls are here decorating their friend.
Okay.
In preparation to meet her husband.
Okay. The medium is oil on board.
It's oil on canvas.
Oil on canvas.
Oil on canvas.
But it's board, I'm seeing
it. It's mounted on a board.
Okay. Oil on canvas.
Yes.
That's a very beautiful work. Mm. And then what's the title of this other one?
This one is titled Precarious Vision.
Precarious Vision.
Precarious Vision.
I see it's a surrealistic work.
Yes.
And you know, in most surrealistic works, you talk about how the mind conceived of it. What were you thinking of when you did this work?
In fact, having studied man and his existence on earth,
yes,
I came to realize that a lot of factors militate against our being on earth.
Okay.
Some are for, some are against.
Yes.
In fact, if, as you can see here, there is a human being here.
Okay.
Now, surrounded by a lot of factors which a human being cannot decipher.
Okay.
Our existence on earth are being influenced by some of these factors. Some of them are coming from the sphere.
Yes.
Some of them are coming from the earth,
yes,
beneath. Some of them are coming from the sphere.
Okay.
So all these things, the aggregate of all these things determine our being on this earth.
Okay.
That was why I painted this work. Having
you called it
precarious vision.
Precarious vision.
What I meant by that is that you cannot determine what will happen in the next 1 minute.
Okay.
As a human being, no matter how you forecast.
This has the map of Africa cast against a beggar or a poor man, more like a destitute here. Sorry, what's the title of this work?
The title of this work is Africa in Precipitous Impasse.
Mm, yes. I can understand that.
Having studied the condition, the factors militating our stay, our being on this continent, being Africa, I discovered that,
okay,
being a Nigerian,
okay,
I portrayed the mouth of Africa to be where Nigeria is,
okay,
located.
Okay.
Nigeria being referred as the giant of Africa.
Okay.
Now, Africa is, I mean, Nigeria cannot do the whole problem facing Africa alone.
Okay.
That was why the South Africa, which is a mixed race,
okay,
black and white, covered the underwear. That is wearing underwear here. That is the, okay, map where South Africa is located.
Okay.
But a lot of factors beyond our control, we Africa, beyond our control, are militating against our state.
Okay.
Here you see external force pulling Africa,
okay,
the stool on which Africa is resting.
Okay.
These things are the people who are against the progress or the welfare of Africa.
Okay.
Those who want to supply us arms.
Okay.
Over here, they are supplying us arms to fight ourselves.
Okay.
When they trigger off the war,
okay,
they will, the other side be selling us their arms. You see, gun, machetes, dollars, pounds, and other currencies we cannot decipher. They are inside this plate.
Okay. Okay.
But this one is trapped in the dance of destiny.
Okay, trapped in the dance.
Trapped in the dance of destiny.
That's a very, very,
yes,
pungent title.
Yeah.
But I can't see dances here, so.
You can see it in the abstract realm because,
okay,
the images are somehow dancing.
Okay.
A lot of things are happening behind this painting.
Okay.
This is a forest scape.
Okay.
As if you are looking at the forest from the area, casting an area view of the forest.
Okay.
Now, the title of this work is Interchange in Nature.
Okay.
Nature does not exist on its own.
Okay.
A lot of things make up nature.
Okay.
And the trees, the birds, the animals,
okay,
the immaterials, all of them come into existence here. Okay. As you can see, they are intertwined.
Yes.
These three drummers are celebrating life.
Okay.
They are dancing to the rhythm of life.
Okay.
In fact, it is a reminiscence of what the experiences I had when I was living in Yoruba land.
Bumpy as the terrain of arts is in terms of material gratification, MBONU Christopher Emerem soldiers on. Not daunted by the obstacles posed by the Nigerian economy, the economist turned artist believes art is food not just for the body, but also for the soul. For according to him, he decided to stay put with arts out of clairvoyance and not economic consideration. He thus believes that art is not just a profession, but a way of life and a destiny.
You told me you had traveled out of this country. Where in particular?
Now, in 1993.
Yes.
In fact, since I started this art,
yes,
I've had three invitations to come and exhibit in the United States.
Okay.
But the American embassy frustrated my efforts.
Okay.
I was denied visa three times.
Okay.
Whenever I come there, they say that if I go to America, I'll not come back.
Okay.
I started wondering why. They have seen my work, but they refused to give a visa.
Okay.
So, until 1994, when the German consular gave me a multiple visa to travel to Germany,
okay,
to meet some galleries and museums,
okay,
to show them my works.
Okay. One would wonder, why would you leave a lucrative profession like economics and now take to arts? Why?
Now, your question is very well put.
Yes.
Because what I'm doing here is not, I didn't just dabble into art.
Okay.
One night in 1984, that was immediately after my youth service program, when I was living in at Ongwarimi, something woke me up by 1 a.m. and told me that I was wasting my time. Showed me a lot of things, a lot of sceneries, that this is what I'm called to come and portray. So told me that I shook hands with me that I was wasting my time. So
yes,
since that time,
yes,
I started painting. I took my work seriously.
Okay. Predominantly, what I see, aside from your celebration of humanity, is that you take particular interest in surrealism as a form of art. Is that the reason for it?
That is one of the reasons.
Okay.
As I said earlier, a lot of influences in my life have shaped my life in this pattern. Now, whatever I do, whatever I paint,
yes,
whatever I conceive,
yes,
come as a flow. They come naturally. I cannot repeat one work. All these are abstract paintings, cannot be repeated.
Okay.
You see, some of these paintings that look like flying colors, they cannot be repeated. They are as a result of influences, because influences are dynamic. They continue to change. Each environment, each situation, each mood of life determines what I will create.
Okay.
So, and when they come, I portray what is handed to me at that very point in time.
How do you get your inspiration?
My inspiration comes in different forms.
Okay.
I might be sleeping now. Something might steer me.
Okay.
Inwardly.
Okay.
Or as I'm walking along the road, I may be watching, I may be looking, I may be seeing a beggar. Just like one work I called, every disabled person is settled with an abled person.
Okay.
Just like a beggar, a blind beggar, has somebody who is heady, who is taking him or her around. So such things are touching me passionately as an artist. So when I see such things, I try to put them into painting, to keep them alive, to let other human beings realize that we should be careful on our stay in this earth.
have you been able to reflect the way life has treated you on your art?
Thank you very much. Life has been treating me fine. In fact, I'm very, very happy that God had been able to sustain me up to date. Because I've been involved in a lot of accidents, both as a child and as a man. But in each instance, I was able to elude the difficult situation. Now, on the other side also, still on the positive side, I've been able to keep my head above water. By the special grace of God, I've been able to sustain myself.
Where do you see MBONU EMEREM going in the next 10 years?
In the next 10 years, with the help of God, I will make it. And it has to, I'm working in a progressive trend, in a positive direction.
Okay.
With the help of special grace of God, a lot of things will be unfolding for the benefit of mankind.
Now, what would only want to say here that the personality himself that produced all these works actually typifies the best of mankind. Because you can see it reflected on his work, from the religious to the mundane. You see that his strokes on the canvas of time has really made a statement. And that statement is what we have been able to see now, though very briefly. But the creativity of Christopher MBONU EMEREM continues.
Thus far, Christopher EMEREM has not only oiled his skills, but has also come into his own, away from the hindrances and problems that he has had to face. EMEREM soldiers on, and his strokes on the canvas of time are indeed a statement for all times and all seasons.